can I say?
Irving said most important things about it. And also, I want to tell you, British Museum has got 130,000 tablets about many things, medicine, geometries, all aspects of life. And about music, we have about 8 tablets. That is it. And they're not in a very good state. And some of them are in other places, and some are in America, some are in Germany, and so forth. So the whole lot of cuneiform texts about music theory, well, it's about 100 fragments altogether. And so it's not much to go with this. But how do we work it? Next one, the green. Okay. So here we are.
Told you.
That's a good start. Okay, so let's go back. Okay, this is pompously called U3011 because this is the field number. It's got other names, but let's not discuss this for the moment. This was a hand copy done by Oliver Gurney, mentioned by Irving a bit earlier, and it's written in a rather stenographic style, which is not what is done today. But the important of this, the importance of this text, that it is left column is in Sumerian and the right column is in Babylonian. And it's got this sign here, which means sa. Sa is very important because immediately it means something to do about music. String. And it translates roughly, no, not roughly, seriously, because we did this together, Irving and myself. The first one, sadi, in Sumerian, in Akkadian, it is udmu, prime string. So, sa ush, string neighboring, sa three sessing, string three, string thin, sa four two, string four small, sa d five string, d prime string number five, then sa four agagul, string four of the rear, string three of the rear, string two of the rear, string one of the rear, 9 strings. So it means that we've got a system with 9 strings, full stop, in a palindromic order, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, which is most interesting. And this tells us that there might have been an older pentatonic system which existed before this system in question. Now, we have variations here. The four small string in Sumerian, sa for small, is string ea created, that is, it has been handled, perfected by the Goddess. Something has happened in the Akkadian version, which is different than what we have in the Sumerian version. So we have two systems in one bit of tablet. So this is very important because it tells, this text tells us that we've got 9 strings, and it is probably a system of 9 strings. Why? Because all the strings have got their different values in relation to one another, and they are based on 2 conjuncted intervals of 5 pitches. So, next tablet, a fragment also, CBS 10996, comes from Philadelphia, is the CBS, the Catalog Babylonian section. It comes from about 600 BC, more or less, we're not very sure about this. It looks like a cheese grater. I haven't tried it as a cheese grater, but I've been informed that it could be possible on one of these days. If, depending on the presence of the curator or not. Now, this is slightly difficult to read, but this is a reconstruction by a friend of mine, and because we have a pattern of numbers, it was possible to, by extrapolation, to complement what was missing. Okay, I will pass this because this is a bit too complex. And essentially what it does, it lists a series of intervals in a descending order, 1, 5, 2, 6, 3, 7, so forth, and ascending thirds. So therefore we here have a system of descending fifths and a system of ascending third. They are based on a span which is of 13 degrees, which is a complete system, which I will call the greater Babylonian system. And this is important. Each of these intervals has got a name. For instance, you would like to come to give me a little help with this?
Sure.
You got your microphone?
No, it's with you.
Okay, so you see, their system was as follows. Instead of having, like us, something written with dots to give the notes, they simply give names to the intervals. And these were imprinted in the minds of people with a specific series of pitches. For instance, if I say to my singer, who comes directly from Urartu, she's been revived on the occasion, and well, too, you know, well done, I think we have done rather well. And if I say to her, Mbubu, she would straight away sing, okay. And if I ask her, Gitmu, you see, so every name has got a value of pitches. So you do not need to have your musician knowing their line, their staves and things, complex matters. You simply say, Nid Ibli. And here we go. So if I say, let's do a jam session, this, she knows immediately. I can say, for instance, Nishturi, Shalchatu, followed by Kabitu, Tito Kabitu, and you've got a melody which is going. So it's a very practical thing. And let me tell you something, this is exactly what happens today in the Middle East with the Makam system. It is based not on pitches written down the Western way, but on names of intervals, where you have Bayati, Hijazi, and so forth, the same way. So therefore, we have a continuation from the ancient Babylonian system, and which progressed right through the Islamic period and come into our days. It's the same system exactly, with the exception that we today in the Makam system have more complex intervals. Intervals with more than five pitches going in different directions, with microtones added to them and so forth. Now, this is complicated. Simply, but I have to be complicated at times, otherwise I'm not taken seriously. Now, there is a law in that we have our cochlear system, and it is it will respond to intervals which are simple. For instance, our ear likes the interval of the fifth. And therefore, from this, we can establish preferences. And these preferences are found here. And additionally, we discovered in 1906, a certain archaeological Hillbrecht in 1906, discovered tablets in the Temple Library of Nippur, a series of numbers which are regular numbers. And regular numbers are basically the multiples of the size of the right angle triangle, except when you've got seven mixed in it. They don't like seven. And this is these numbers, these quantifications, correspond to the natural harmonics of any sound. So they discovered this centuries before we could establish this quantification at the end of the 19th century. Did they do it intentionally? I do not know. But the fact is that these numbers are numbers 8, 10, 7, 26, 48, 600, 540, which are the regular numbers on this tablet, and they correspond exactly to the position of the interval that I showed you before. I would need to prove this. I would need about 2, 3, 4 hours to take it for granted. It works this way. So they had a very complex system of quantification, which also works with the ratios as the Greeks used later on. The Greeks preferred ratios. The Babylonians preferred to have quantifications because they permitted more subtle microtones. Next, this is a really, really remarkable text of U780. It's from around, it's all Babylonian, it's from around 1800 BC. This actually is a copy of a cast, which is in the British Museum. The original tablet was sent back to Iraq in the 70s. I was in Baghdad 2 weeks ago. I couldn't find it. I hope to find it one of these days. Now, it's a small thing, it's about this size. And this is a remarkable bit of Babylonian scholarship. What it does, it sets different, it establishes the values of different scales using a method which was never used after by any civilization. It consists in finding within a scale the tritone, descodated tritone. Then to correct one of the pitches of the tritone, so generating another scale, in which scale there's another tritone, and the correction of one of the pitches leads to another scale, and so forth, until it reaches the middle of the tablet here, and then the process is reversed. So we have this way a system of seven descending sets going semitone higher at the end and reverse to a second semitone lower at in the second part. So this system, which dates 1800 BC, was certainly the system that was used for the ecclesiastical modes in the first millennium AD. So this is the basis of our Gregorian chant. So therefore, this is born in Babylonia around 2000 BC, 4,000 years ago. So it's quite remarkable. I could tell you more about it, but I'm sure it is. It would be not appropriate today to take too long. Now, this is this tablet in transliteration, which is, I think, quite sufficient for you with your knowledge of Babylonian that you acquired with Irving's talent. You can go through this quite happily. You might not get the accent right, but this one is not too important. Now, this is exactly what it does. For those who can read music, the text you have seen in his reconstruction gives scales in a thetic notation and in a dynamic notation. So it's a remarkable feast of scholarship. And this is 4,000 years old. Hello. This text is also crucially important. CBS 1766, around 500 BC, with plus or minus a century on each way. It was thought to be an astrological text because of seven-pointed star. But one student from Holland managed to read that at the points of the stars, it was the name of the strings, as we knew them from an older tablet. And also here, we've got columns, which give series of numbers, which indicate alternation of fifths and fourths in order to create a heptatonic scale that we find later in Greece although not confirmed because the manuscript is not authentic on different problems. But let us say that this is the first proof that a heptatonic construction existed around 500 BC. Most important. This is what it says. You see, you have here the star, the two columns in numbers, and what they mean here, 2663 37 7441 1552. It is the first attestation of the construction of a heptatonic system, which Greek theoreticians say it is 2-3 centuries later. So this was much in advance. Now, having had the idea of placing the musical system on the circle, they managed to determine that a semitone would be described by an angle of 30 degrees and a tone an angle of 60 degrees. So therefore, they have discovered the equal temperament about 3,000 years before we invented it in the West. The only problem, they couldn't use it, because it's fine to invent something, but if you have a technique to apply it, then there's no point. Okay, now this is the transition between the linear system and the circular system. If you take a linear rope with the names of the strings, and if you wrap it around a circle, then you realize that you've got two obsolete pitches. This is how from a 9-degree system you end up with a 7-degree system. It is a transition between inatomic system and heptatonic system. Now, because we have got little time left, this is a tablet called H6, which is written in Hurrian. Hurrian is not a Semitic language, it is an agglutinative language, and it has been written quite badly by somebody who could write Babylonian. It was badly damaged. You can see the right part was burnt, almost to make it impossible to translate, to read. Now, the top part gives the lyrics, the text, and the part below is the music. Now, I will not explain to you I spent about 20 years translating this thing. These are the names of the intervals, and the numbers are the added values at the end of each series. And this is the transliteration, the tonal transliteration. Now, Sévan Habib has been working with me on a modal adaptation of this, guided by eminent Syrian and Iraqi musicians, and she will now sing it with the original text in Hurrian. Thank you. This piece was written about 1300 BC, and it was there was no concession to modern theory in it. It is exactly what was written on the tablet. Thank you very much.
For both of our speakers and the brilliant performance. I'm sure we've learned a lot today, not a lot about the primacy of the Mesopotamian system, over everything else, but I do hope there's a tiny bit left for you to keep your interest in the exhibition too.